My name is Salih, and today I want to talk about two dangers of artificial intelligence. One of them is job loss. You know, we're going to lose our jobs in theory. And the second one is singularity. First, let me explain how we're going to lose our jobs. In 1995, Gary lost against the IBM's artificial intelligence called Deep Blue. This artificial intelligence, this was a milestone in artificial intelligence technology. This AI simply calculated all the possibilities and made the best move out of these calculations. But I see some of you guys look like this isn't intelligence, it is just calculating. Calm down, we are coming to that. In 2015, AlphaGo, an artificial intelligence, won a Go game against the best Go player in the world. The difference between chess and Go is in Go, the number of possibilities are more than the number of atoms in the universe. So you can't just calculate it. What this artificial intelligence did was it played millions of games against itself and learned how to play and even make its own strategies. And now, the artificial intelligence started to think. In 2017, as you can see, deep learning algorithm did as well as dermatologists in identifying skin cancer. You might say, as well as won't replace the doctors, people will still go to the doctors. But did you notice the dates? The first one was 1995, then it was 2015, and then it was 2017. As you can see, technology improves exponentially. And the main reason of this is the Moore's Law. According to Moore's Law, in every 2 years, the number of transistors in the same area will double. You may say this graph doesn't look linear, but if you look at the y-axis, it is actually exponential, 1, 10,000, so go on. Indirectly, Moore's Law says in every 2 years, the size of a transistor will double down. This is the reason why in the 1980s, computers was filling a room, but now we can put them in our pockets. And with this exponential shrink, in 20 years, they will be in our veins, traveling our body, constantly looking for these diseases and any abnormal situations. And this will eliminate the need of a doctor. Exactly this point, let me pass to the second part of my presentation, singularity. This term, we borrowed this from physics. It simply means that exponentially improving artificial intelligence will pass our intelligence. We will not be able to contest with this kind of complexity. So, there are two scenarios of this situation. The number one scenario is they will be so much complicated than our thinking, so we won't be able to understand how this artificial intelligence works. So we don't know what output it is going to give us when we give an input. For example, when we say the artificial intelligence saved the nature, it might start saving the nature by first getting rid of all the human beings, we don't want to be. Or in the second scenario, they will be so much more intelligent than us, they become to see us like we see the ants. Ants are not our enemy, they are no threat. But if they stand in our way when we do something, we will get rid of them with no hesitance. You might think these are all despotic, these are not possible. But according to a survey done by Vincent Miller among the artificial intelligence experts, the high-level machine and intelligence will be developed in 2040 or 2050 with a 50% of chance. And when the time hits to 2075, the chance is rising to the 90%. As you can see, this is not far away from now. To conclude, today I talked about how the artificial intelligence will replace us in job industry and then create a singularity and pass our imagination. And to conclude, we have to say that if we are going to study in artificial intelligence, we have to be so much careful. Thank you for listening. These are my references. If you have any question, I'm glad to answer them.